Hey guys, this is Jeroen from Roll on White Scars with a Roll on White Scar Battle Report. Today I'm with
Jesse.
What are we going to play, Jesse?
Hobbit.
We're going to play the Hobbit, yes. Yeah, because we're doing this time in an English special for the GBHL podcast. Because here in Games vs. World Dam, as Roll on White Scars, we are supporting our Hobbit Hobby!
How many points are you going to play?
Yeah, how much points are we going to play?
520.
520.
And which army are you going to play?
I'm going to play the Gundabad warband.
Yeah, and I'm going to play with my dwarves and Saruman the White to get
magic,
maybe?
No, Necromancer.
Okay,
Necromancer.
Right. We're going to roll for the deployment and we'll be back with you with the
And these are my Dugudur 520 points to start with. Necromancer, one Cassadin of Dugudur with Morgul Blade, another Cassadin with Dugudur Blade, well, Morgul Blade, and then I got 11 Gundabad Orcs and a Gundabad Captain with what you see is what you get, and there are my 550 points.
520, you mean yes?
520. I'm sorry.
Alright, guys, we're starting with my 520 points of Dwarf Holds, including Saruman the White in good version. Starting off, Saruman the White, and he will lead a warband of 8 Dwarf Warriors. 5 of them have a bow. And 3 have just an axe and a shield. A second warband is Thor and Oaken Shields with Dwalin. They will accompany together and will kick some ass. And my third warband is my shield bearer with. What was it? Oh yeah, I got 8 dwarf warriors. 3 of them have shields, 4 of them have two-handed weapons, and 1 has a banner to reroll everything. And that's the entire army. 520 points of Dwarf Wolves and Saruman! Alright, Jess and I have rolled for the mission. We're going to play to the death. I'm going to start on this side, and Jess is going to start on this side. This is the board we are playing on. It's a ruined field in the Iron Hills. So we have a lot of ruins, the ravens in the middle, with uncreated Grim Hammer statues. And a nice Thor statue, your grandfather, why not? So, okay, I'm going to roll while my warbands are starting. First off, I will do Saruman. 2, so he starts in the middle within 12 inch. Board to Thorin and Dwalin. I can choose wherever they want. And the shield bearer with the instrument, 1. So, this unit and that unit has to deploy within 12 inches. And Thor and Dwalin can choose wherever they like.
Okay, cool. Then we go to my deployment. Well, we're going to see whether my warband is going to deploy. First, Castellan. That's 1. Second, can choose wherever he wants. The Necromancer. Also within 12 inches of the beginning of the war. And the Gundabad Orcs. Also.
Well.
That went well.
Alright, we check you guys back when we are deployed.
We've been deploying on the bridge right now, and I've learned of my mistakes, because in a previous video I would put all the models in the front, but then you will be trapped if you lost the fight, so that's why the space in the middle. And then the necromancer in the back, and that's it, basically, just a clash.
Do you have any battle plan, necromancer?
No, I don't, just...
I got the armor!
Alright, we're going to my deployment. Right, I deployed. This is first.
Down here,
I deployed Thorin and Dwarven together. I have to deploy them like this because you have to start a new warband job. Behind that, I've deployed my shield bearer and his unit. And behind that, I deployed Saruman and the warriors. And I also put a little bit of space into it so I can't be trapped. Yes, sir. My tactic? Time to slay Sauron. He's mine.
So the necromancer. It did not take physical force. Form yet.
Leave him to me. Shall we all die for priority? Yes.
Let's all die for priority.
Alright, let's do it right here then. That's an artillery die, so.
Let's try again.
One, and I have four.
No.
Oh, so no. I go first. So let's go into turn one. Right, you just had turn one. I priority, so I moved in. Won the combat with Dwalin. I have to use might for it. I give him a wound, but he used two of his will points to use as fate, so he survived. My shield bearer also won, didn't do a wound. And Thorin also won, but didn't do a wound. Move my dwarf warriors with bows to the side, and with Saruman I try to cast Sorcerer's Blast on this Gundabad orc, but I failed to cast.
Which is nice.
For you, yeah. And that was my turn.
Well, then we go to my turn recap.
There's a problem.
Well, I cannot much add to what Jeroen just said, only that I also tried to cast Chill Soul, but I failed. Well, I did, I made it, but Jeroen did denied it with
yeah, I dispelled it with Saruman, so...
That was turn one. Let's go to turn two.
Yeah, priority. Show your off priority.
Three. Gives me.
Three.
You had it last time.
So that means you have priority turn two. Yeah, yes, sir. Take my coin. It's priority.
The coin. The priority coin.
All right, we're going on to turn two.
Well,
Legion.
I charged Jeroen. Jeroen shoot at me, killed my Gundabad orc, unfortunately. Cast that Sorcerer's Blast on my necromancer so he is prone. And during the combat phase, Dwalin has drained my Castellan to three whale points. So he's almost gone, but not yet. And in the combat with Thorin, I used my Morgul Blade, but did nothing, unfortunately. So now we go on to Jeroen. Turn two. Recap.
All right, we just had my turn two. What happened? Moved a little bit over here with my dwarves, took some shots, killed one Gundabad with shield, lucky shot. Yes, I cast Chill Soul again on Saruman. It went off this time, and I got a wound, but I prevented it with fate, so it cost me one fate. Yeah, in return, I gave the necromancer Sorcerer's Blast, and he went 4 inches back, and he didn't get a wound. And just as Jess told you, just one of his Castellans has now three.
Yes, points. That's right.
Right, the captain was standing there. Lost the combat, didn't wound him, and Thorin lost the combat but didn't die about the Morgul Blade. So, yeah, that was pretty much it. Should we roll for priority?
Yes, we do.
Cool. Then we roll in here. In the river! Oh, I already have it. Can I have my coin?
You can have the coin.
Thank you. It's mine.
Priority coin.
Yeah.
It's on, yours again.
Yes. On to turn three.
Yeah.
Right, just at turn three. What happened? Well, I've cast Sorcerer's Blast again on Simon the Necromancer. It did go off, but Jesse stopped it with a will point. I've got to shoot, because I want to kick ass here. So, mistake for me. Rookie mistake in the combat. Dwanen finished off one of the castellans. He was out of his will points and he gained two off. The only thing is, I had to give my last might point on for it. So, Dwanen has no might anymore. My shield bearer one didn't do anything at all, and Thorin one as well, but didn't do anything at all. And yeah, that was my turn. Also, the recap from yesterday.
Well, again, I have not much to add to that, only that the Necromancer again did chill soul and it went off. But Jeroen uses his fate.
No, I used a will point and a might point for
it. A will point and a might point to secure his wounds. So, well, that was it. So roll for priority again.
Yeah, let's do that.
4.
I got a 5.
Well, you keep the priority coin.
I will keep holding the coin and I will have turn 4 priority.
Yes. Turn 4, quite uneventful actually. My necromancer couldn't do anything because he was blown back again by Saruman. His dwarf shot one orc dead, and they drained two of my will points from my last castellan. And that's it, actually. Dwarf armor is pretty tough, I guess.
Okay.
Jeroen's recap.
Just had turn 4. What happened? I had priority, so I Sorcerer's Blast again. Sauron the Necromancer. Goodbye, die. I shot him 5 inch back. I didn't wound him, but yes, he tried to dispel it. It failed. I was out of range with this dwarf. This dwarf shot into this one, shot here on the wall, so nothing happened. Here I shot 3, and the one as well in the back. And 2 one hits, 2 went through the wall, but I didn't wound him. And in close combat, Dwalin had to face 2 spearmen, and he killed 1. So yeah. That's it. The
priority?
Yeah.
Turn 5?
6, so you have it.
I have it.
Yes,
give me the coin. Give me the coin.
You're getting the coin, my friend.
Give me the coin. Yeah, turn 5.
Turn 5. Right, just at turn 5, what happened? I moved in, tried to shoot with my dwarf archers on this guy, hit him 2 times, but my arrows were sticking in the wall, so nothing happened. In close combat, Dwalin killed another guy, and that's it. On to the recap from Jesse.
Well, my turn 5 was fun, because it was the first kill of many. I killed one dwarf warrior, just a warrior, with my captain, so...
Yeah. The first one fell.
Slowly coming in, just taking his time, getting blasted back a few times, but it doesn't matter. He will come there.
Okay.
That was my turn 5.
Yeah, that's roll priority. Roll priority.
Yeah.
Oh.
A 1.
A 1, yeah. So I get it, no matter what.
You have also a 1.
I have also a 1, but... Yes, sir. Give me the coin.
I don't want to give you the coin.
Thank you. Turn 6.
Turn 6. Well, turn 6 was... turn 6 was okay. I killed another dwarf warrior in combat with my captain, I thought. Yeah, my captain, because he was pressing fierce striking and he lost the fight. Necromancer moved up, and that's about it. And a recap of turn 6.
Yeah, turn 6. What happened? I walked back with Saruman and the dwarf archers because the necromancer is coming in and I can't shoot anything. Just moved a little bit forward. I trapped the captain, but I lost because of might, so yes, I won that. And killed one of my dwarf warriors with shield again. Shooting phase, I tried to shoot with my 3 dwarf archers, hit twice on the necromancer, but they stick to the fence again, so nothing. And in close combat, Dwarren lost the first time. He didn't get one wound from Yasser, but with faith I prevented it. And Thorin killed the Castellan, so that one is gone as well.
Such a shame.
Such a shame.
Such a shame.
Shall we roll for turn 7? Yes, sir.
We will roll for turn 7.
Alright.
Oh, which one was it?
Roll again.
I believe it was the 6.
I think it was the 3, but okay.
3.
Alright. Yeah. So it means I have turn 7. Yeah, turn 7. Pretty good turn for me. So, here in the shooting phase, I try to shoot on these guys. Yes, we'll tell you how they are coming by there. So, shot on them, but 2 didn't wound, and my other one didn't hit it. So, they hit
the statue
or something. In combat, I had a trapped captain here. I won the combat, and I give him 1 wound.
Use my fate, but fate was not with us today.
Not with you.
Thorin Oakenshield.
Not with you, my friend. And Dwalin won his fight as well, and he killed 2 Gundabad orcs. Thorin won his fight, and he killed 1 Gundabad orc with 1 might, so he's down to 2 might, but with that, Jesse is also broken.
That is.
Jesse is broken. So, yeah, let's go to Jesse's recap.
Well, if you look over here, the necromancer was down with the failures of the orcs, so he was... So he commanded them to jump over the fences so he can move forward himself. So we hope that this turn he will charge and kill something. Needs to kill something, right? And stink. Yeah, well, that was pretty much it. You told everything about the combat phase. So now we go to turn 7?
Turn 8.
Turn 8? Priority?
Yeah, priority.
Three.
He has a 3. And I have a 4, so...
Unbelievable.
The coin stays with me.
Turn 8.
Turn 8.
Turn 8 was, well, fun, I guess. The necromancer charged in, got a wound, saved it with 4 will points.
4 will points.
Thorin also slayed an orc of mine, and this stupid orc fell off the fence and got shot at, but didn't get killed. So that was really my turn 8. Recap from who's turn it.
Yeah, we just had turn 8. What happened? Pretty much trapped the captain that was standing there. Did heroic strike, and he had 5/5/10. And
then, double ones!
Then he rolled snake eyes, so yeah, he was trapped, and with Dwalin with strength 5, I needed force plus 1 from the 2 hand, so I chopped him down. With Thorin, I used also a heroic strike, and I had also 5/5/10. I won combat, and I killed one of the Gundabads that was standing there, and I gave Sauron the Necromancer wound, but he survived. And yeah, my archers tried to shoot the fallen Gundabad orc, but they failed again in statue, so yeah, I don't know, I don't think they can shoot with something right. Don't know what she's doing, what... You see an orc falling, and still you shoot the statue. Maybe it's the height, I don't know. So, shall we roll for priority?
Yeah, it's time for priority for me.
Alright.
Two.
And I got a 5.
So
priority is mine, my friend.
Yet again.
Well, the Necromancer was charged by Thorin, Dwalin, and Captain, I think?
The Shield Bearer.
Yeah, the Shield Bearer. I had 1 attack, rolled 3. Jeroen rolled with Thorin a 6. I won with that. Did 3 wounds, which cost me free will.
I won and you lost by combat.
Yeah, well, correct. So now I have... Then Will left for turn 10, I think. Turn 9.
No, turn 10.
Turn 10. Well, the recap for the rules, turn 9.
Right, we just had turn 9. Moved up a little bit. Thorin charged it in. He had double 6 for his courage. Dwalin didn't have to have his courage test because he's a bodyguard and shield bearer as well, so they automatically pass every terror test and courage test. So they walked in, tried to shoot again on the guy, again the fench.
Super fench.
The super fench indeed, and these two guys joined their brothers. And that's pretty much it. We're going to priority
10.
Yeah.
6. I get it.
So the
finally,
the evil overlord gets his coin.
Yes, thank you.
Here you go.
Well, there was turn 10 and it was awesome. I slain Dwalin, and that sounds pretty much the turn up. Recap from you.
Yeah, turn 10. I lost Dwalin.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, he's instant killed by the Necromancer and I had 1 fate point left, so I'm sorry brother, you fell. Furthermore, in the shooting with my dwarves, they shot one of the Gundabads down.
Finally,
so
after all these years.
After all the years of practicing on a just normal stupid statue, I finally
and
killed
a fence.
And fench, yeah. If there was really some arrows in the fench and statue, I was completely full with with the arrows. But yeah, I killed one. So we're now going to turn 11. That will be the last one because Jess is beneath 25%. So yeah, priority. Who have it? The Evil Overlord or Will Thorin with Saruman do something? I have the last turn.
It's his last turn because we both rolled a 4.
Give him my coin.
The coin.
Thank you.
The coin. The priority coin.
The priority coin. Alright, on to turn 11.
Last one.
Well, the recap of turn 11, nothing happened. I lost the fight, and Jeroen did no wounds. That was turn 11.
Alright, we just had turn 11. Nothing happened. I charged in, used my last might point to get 5-5-10. Yes, I had 2 sixes.
Yes, I did.
And I had as well 6 with Thorin, so I won. So he lost 1 will point. He's down now at 8.
Yes, that's correct.
And that was it. We scored the points as well, so we're going to the aftermatch.
Well, the final score is 6-0.
Yeah.
So, well, it was a nice game. Pretty much make the same mistakes like it did last time.
Well, it's hard. Defense at least at 7. I lost 3 models there. They're standing there, so. That's pretty much it. The castellans are really tough. And if you had killed Thorin with your
Morgul blade.
Then
skank.
Then would be in a entire different game. But yeah, in the end, it is now 0-0. I have my banner still remaining. And yes, it's broken, and I didn't break, so that those were the only things we could find in the rule book. So, 6-0. Yes, sir. Thank you.
And support your Hobbit hobby.
Support your Hobbit hobby.
Support your Hobbit hobby.